First up tonight, out there in suburbia, there's a new growth industry that's emerged, and it ain't Tupperware. According to police, so-called hydro houses are popping up at an alarming rate, producing vast amounts of top-grade marijuana. Crime syndicates are preying on the weak and vulnerable, and the cops can't bust them quickly enough. Here's Eddie Meyer.
A quiet suburban street, unremarkable in every way except one. There is something here amid the family homes, hiding in plain sight. A hydroponic hothouse. In almost every room, cannabis. But this isn't a one-off.
Yep, here and there, in the far left corner. With you.
Operation Zambezi has been going for just 6 months. This is the 74th hit. In nearly every case, police found exactly the same thing. Now meet the officers spearheading it, Sydney's Southwest Metropolitan Region Enforcement Squad.
The premises has a high level of fortification. There's a photograph there of Google Images. There's a large metal fence erected around the property, roller shutters on each window.
It's the 74th Zambezi search warrant, which means nothing changes for us. We still do it as if it's our first one, with the same intensity and the same professionalism.
They are highly trained specialists, disciplined, determined, and on this day, the house they hit is barely two streets away from a police station. Neighbours are stunned, oblivious to the danger, just doors away.
It was a bit scary thing for me. If they say they are growing marijuana here, this is a good suburb. We live in here for quite a long time now. I've been here for the last 10 years.
And there is danger. The cannabis itself is force-fed powerful toxic chemicals to turbocharge growth and potency. The result, a crop so pungent, the distinctive odour can be smelled in the street as soon as the doors are opened. Expensive charcoal filters are installed to prevent the smell from escaping. To power the dozens of expensive high-intensity lamps and transformers, the gangs bypass the electricity supply with dodgy wiring. And that's not all.
You never know what you're confronted with. Each house is totally different. We've been to premises where there's been booby-trapped, there's been firearms, ammunition located inside.
Now, this house was only taken over by the syndicate 3 months ago, so in all likelihood, this is their first crop. And this is where police hope to make their greatest impact. Given the huge investment in setting up a house like this, they've hit this syndicate before they've even made their first profit.
In the early stages, we're targeting about a house every second day.
Assistant Commissioner Frank Manilli commands what could be the biggest urban cannabis crackdown ever undertaken.
Well, I think we've been effective purely because we're meticulous with our intelligence and the information that we act on. And once we have that confirmed, we're quite quick and swift. We go in, we eradicate the crop, regardless of whether the individual's at home or not. The crop, the equipment is destroyed.
That, he says, takes the drugs off the streets and stops the criminals from making any money, putting them out of business.
I think criminal enterprises are established believing that this is a means of making quick money with low risk. We've certainly shown them that the risks are extremely high because we've been able to identify and target and address each of these locations.
Police search warrant! Open the door!
But the approach used by this squad represents a major shift in tactics. This is purely about disruption. Arrests are not the main game, they're a bonus. Those in the homes are usually low-level crop sitters.
It is extremely difficult to actually get the organisers. So I did not want to risk the opportunity of some of the cannabis actually ending up on the street. So it was a fairly decisive decision to make to go in and just eradicate these premises and to stop them from re-establishing somewhere else.
The profits can be phenomenal. Seized here, 100 mature plants ready for harvest, worth $500,000 on the streets, and the gangs can turn over 6 crops a year in every house. So the raids will continue, possibly in a quiet suburban street near you.
Please,
a bit more lucrative than Tupperware.